What is up, chat? What is up? How good is this menu? How good is this main menu? All right, chat, we got a lot of business to take care of at the top. Okay? First up. Okay, let's get into the dark business first. Classic mode, dude. Right, should we keep classic mode, chat? Should we keep it? I kind of just want to blast people away tonight. You know what I mean? Classic, I've done it. I've showed you the receipts. I've showed you the trophy. Like, we've done it. Yeah, I just want to blast people away tonight. So we're going to turn it down to just hard, which I appreciate. You know? Hard. Still retains a lot of the feeling. But just a little less, you know, just a little less. I want to be able to blast tonight. So, and we already turned it down in the race. You know, if you've tuned into these streams before, it's fine. How is everyone doing tonight? Hard eights were flowing, but also not flowing. Chat, I was in Las Vegas this morning. We are here now. It was good times. It was what I needed. I went with a friend who I've known since first grade. And a friend since I've known since high school, ninth grade, lives there. Who also lived, like, we all lived in the same city, you know? Yeah, so it was just like, good vibes, dude. All three of us, dude. Just like, we went to gamble and we gambled. Chat. Like, just super fun. Craps is my obsession, chat. I can't even handle it. I cannot even handle craps. It is my favorite thing. It is my absolute favorite thing. It was one of the last things my brother ever taught me, was craps. So it's pretty heavy. He loved it. And I remember playing with him, dude, and we were just all about that hard eight, dude. It was just good vibes, man. Love it. So then, this time, one of my friends had never played it. And then I was, like, rusty because I'd only played it with my brother. And then our other friend was, like, good at it. So craps, chat, was the theme of the weekend. So many stories. You will get into them. It's out of control. Fucking, like, these people from Vancouver sat down, dude. This, like, son and mom. This guy's, like, 40. His mom's probably 70. He's super into blackjack. She's never played. They sit down with us. We got you. Like, your dream in Vegas is to sit down with us three. That's it. Because we were just like, let's go, dude. Good vibes. So they were all like nervous. Like, she didn't know how to play. The mom. And my friends are really good. Like, chat. Like, I am competent at gambling. You know, I know the rules of it all. And I'm very comfortable. But my brain can't handle the numbers. You know what I mean? You know me. I can't handle that in my brain. Are you kidding me? Numbers. You know, I'm all about, like, the feel. That's my superpower. Is the feel. Like, yo, this table, this time, these people. Let's play, let's not, you know? So that's me. They're all about the numbers and the strats. So, like, we all make a good team, dude. And then those people joined in, dude. It was just so fun. It was just, oh. Craps tables, too, dude. Everyone's jolly. Chat, dude. All I want to do is just play craps with all of you right now. Everyone is, oh, it's so jolly. Everyone is just a little more open there, you know? You go there to be a little more open. to, like, human interaction and conversation. I really appreciate it, chat. I really appreciate that side of Vegas. You know? Good vibes. Good vibes. Everyone's just like, yo, chill. Someone came up. Dude, this Australian guy came up. My friend was playing three-card poker. I didn't play. I've never played. I didn't play. I was just watching my friend. Australian solo guy comes up. And he's like, hey, do you think you could tell me how you play this? And I'm just like, yo, dude, I can't, but my friend is about to. Because my friend was, like, cashing out. I'm like, my friend is about to. My friend comes, like, dude, can you tell this person how to play? And they're just talking about it, dude, how to play. It's so jolly, dude. Jolly vibes. Tommy Angelo, trip to the country.
Back then, everything went through Frank. The plans, the orders, the money. You could get the call day or night.
Tommy. Frank says to wait for him in the garage out in the back. Eh? You got the job, I think.
Thanks, Luigi. Sarah's cooking. She's bringing something over.
In this rain? She's a good girl.
I'll see you tomorrow, Luigi.
See you tomorrow, bud.
Sure. Back in the day, when the boss was still with that phone, he got called out to a hit. Some politician on the take. Now this storm's just raging. And we're driving out to the burbs to cap this guy. The street lights weren't so good, so we're driving in the dark. We get to the house. We're about to make our move. And then there's this lightning flash. And for a split second, in the front yard, I see this head just sitting there, staring, cut off at the neck.
Nah, this ain't true.
Some other crew had already been out to the house that night. Guess the guy had more than his share of enemies. They never found the body.
Bullshit.
God's truth.
Hey, Tommy. You good?
Yeah. Wet, but good.
Nice, Nemo. Awesome. Great series. I like the original, and this, and two. And three's good. They're all great. They're all great.
Thanks for waiting, Tom. The Don and I had to go over last month's numbers again.
Sure. So what's the job?
I want you to help Sam and Polly with the shipment we've got coming in tonight.
Good stuff.
Straight from Canada.
Where do you need
Boardwalk.
Sam's going to meet our friends from the north at the
Nucky farm. Thompson!
Polly will oversee the trucks bringing the shipment into the city, but I want you to go with him. Be an extra pair of eyes. Make sure it all goes smoothly.
Okay.
Get the car from Murphy. Yeah. Meet Polly at the warehouse. He's got heaters in case you run into any trouble.
Sure, Frank. No problem.
Good. Now bring the Canadian home safe, Tommy. There is already a case earmarked for the Don.
Hell yeah, dude. Call Tommy in here, you know? You bring Tommy into this, dude. It's all hands on deck. Polly, dude, hothead. Sam, obviously, like, running the operation. You need Tommy as the level head, making sure this operation goes down smooth. That's why we're here, chat. We gotta make sure this job goes down easy.
This motor's yours, if you want it, Tommy.
Thanks, Ralph.
Working late, Ralphie?
I just asleep when Frank sleeps. Man, he's been working us hard.
Morello's taking bites out of business everywhere else, Ralph. Bull's Racket's where we shine. We gotta stay ahead someplace.
Ah, well, I just fixed the cars to Tom. I changed the plates again. You can't be too careful.
See you tomorrow.
Okay.
Hell yeah. Such a sick car.
Now brings you a special weather report.
Weather.
The heavens have opened, folks, and we're experiencing some adverse effects across the municipal area. A large storm front, not expected to arrive for several days, hit Lost Heaven late this afternoon, releasing a deluge of rainfall on the city. If you've been out in the last couple of hours, you don't need me to tell you. There are reports coming in of a number of traffic accidents attributed to the downpour, with fender benders occurring in Oakwood and Chinatown. A more serious accident has occurred near the White Harbor Hotel, which is causing traffic to back up on the East Marshall Bridge all the way into downtown. The police department is attending incidents as they can, but they've now issued advice that people should not venture out on the roads unless their journey is strictly necessary. The roads are treacherous, ladies and gentlemen, so however a good driver you may be, it's just not worth the risk to you or anyone else. It would seem the best thing to do on a night like this is to stay at home with your loved ones and keep warm and dry. I know where I'd rather be on a night like this. In addition to the problems we've been hearing about...
That static!
...traffic in and out of the city has been suspended by order of the Aviation Authority. Unscheduled flights departing Lost Heaven International have been grounded, and those scheduled to arrive into that airport have been canceled or diverted elsewhere. Now, as bad as that may sound, the latest report from the weather service that I've just been handed states that although the rain is heavy at this moment, and that all warnings should be heeded, the storm isn't expected to last all that long. Certainly, it doesn't seem like it will be anything like the big one of 1927. High winds are pushing the storm over us at quite a rate. We will, of course, keep you informed with news on the hour. But before I return you to our musical programming, let me reiterate that the Lost Heaven Police Department strongly advises against motor travel at this time. And on a personal note, I advise staying with your family, friends, or loved ones, and waiting out this dreadful storm in the warmth of the home. That's all for now. Some music will be along shortly, and I'll be back to check in with you later. Thank you for listening.
Dude, that announcer had me gripped. Gripping. Absolutely gripping. If anyone knows... If anyone knows, I shouted that out in the review. Radio broadcasts in this game, chat. Top tier. All of it, dude. The music, too. Oh, shit. We're going out there, Chad. It's a trip to the country. Long drive. Legendary mission chat from my youth.
Come on, Tom! Hey, hey! Watch it, pal! Just dry it out!
Sorry. You know this place?
Yeah. We've done a few pickups at the farm before. Don't worry. There ain't nothing but cow shit and shine out here. It's gonna be an easy few clams. Boys will load up the trucks. Come straight back.
Yeah, let's make it quick. I got someplace to be.
You see it, Sarah, later. Luigi's little girl, your night shift. You're something else, pal. Protecting the girl's virginity one day and taking it the next.
Lay off, Polly.
Ah, come on. I'm just kidding. She's a good girl. You settle down, she'll straighten you right out. Going home to a couch. Now, I wonder what kind of story she could tell about her old man, though. Luigi was a stone-cold killer back in the day.
Sick. Luigi.
I wouldn't know.
You know she's been helping out behind a bar since she was a kid. I bet she's seen and heard a few things. Probably knows more about our business than we do.
She knows enough not to ask me too many questions.
That's good. She won't ever make a liar out of you. Christ. Go to Mario just for that.
Dude, Mafia 4 would definitely have Luigi. For sure.
Waiting here, but I don't see
if that's true, prequel?
Something smells off.
Mm-hmm.
Don't let your pecker get all shriveled up. Probably just trying to get out of the rain. Or into the bootleg.
Yes, the dirty lemur, yes. Hell yeah. Yo, I really like that actress in Orphan and the Novice as well.
Let's go find them.
With Luigi. No, Mario.
It's just three sheets, and I'm wrecking a new suit for nothing. I swear I'm gonna kill him. Here. Just in case Frank was right. I'm gonna go grab them boys, get them sorted out. You go ahead, see what's what. Catch up with
see them. What's what. Koshimitsu, 6 months. Stray is close. Yeah, it is. Trip to the country, chat. I like the original Mafia 1 and 2 the most. And then this one's pretty close. And then 3 is like a little behind. I still really like 3. But it's a bit behind the others.
Someone's been waiting here tonight.
Tommy Shelby, dude! Peaky Blinders, chat! Chat, if you're not watching Peaky Blinders... Come on now. No, I don't recommend things anymore. I just hype up what I love. I don't want to recommend anything to you, chat. Because everyone has their 48 show queue. Their 17 game queue. You don't need my recommendations. You know? 1 quarter out of work. February 2nd, 1933. Government report shows no end to slowdown. Measures to date have failed to halt economic slide. Unemployment stands at 25%. Farm foreclosures are at a two-year high. As smallholders battle the combined threat of financial hardships and the dust storms choking the high plains. In response, the president proposes new legislation to stabilize the banking system. Ash just started Peaky Blinders today during lunch. Sick. I really love it. It was a great ride. It was a really great ride, and I'm not going to get into it, but without saying anything, as a final season and considering everything, it's one of the best final seasons of a show in recent memory. That's all I'm gonna say. I really, really thought they stuck the landing hard. Better than Game of Thrones, of course. Of course.
Guy we pay to keep this place in check. Don't even pretend to farm now.
Just a front. Just some farm front. Into bootlegging now, dude. Probably gets bank.
I just don't feel right.
Damn right, dude. Where the fuck is everyone, chat? Missing farmer found dead. Lost Heaven, Illinois, June 17th. Harry Smith, missing for 2 months, was confirmed dead today by the Los Angeles County Coroner Office. A fruitless search led by the farmer's father and neighbors ended several weeks ago. The grisly discovery of the body was made by local children looking for edible mushrooms and berries in woodland local to Cope's farm. The death is not being treated as suspicious due to how Mr. Smith's body was found, hanging by the neck. He is survived by his elderly father. Camo's 347 months. Thanks so much. Nope. I didn't know, chat. I didn't know. I swear I didn't know. I didn't know. Everyone look away. Nope. Sorry.
The place is derelict.
Have we looked at these yet? Empire Bay chat! Carlo Falcone. No criminal can be trusted. Take, for example, Carlo Falcone, the man who murdered his own boss. Years spent at Tomasio Moretta's side frustrated him, with deals unmade and dissent that should have been stamped out plaguing the family. After 2 long years of the Vinci-Moretti gang war, Falcone ended it in his own favor. Moretti died in flames, and Falcone now reigns. What lies ahead remains to be seen. I know what lies ahead, chat. Personally. Paulie Lombardo, dude, that's Paulie. Mob enforcer Paulie Lombardo operates in the streets and alleyways of Little Italy, Lost Heaven. Quick-tempered and fiery, he oversees a tight network of criminals and informants loyal to his boss, Don Salieri. Wherever he walks, he is greeted by the fake smiles of the extorted and the fearful. To earn his displeasure is ill-advised. If he stops to talk, he wants money, not the time of day. Yeah, dude, Paulie. Frank Vinci, Empire Bay. The hush just fell upon this room, a room of politicians, police, and the powerful, was caused by one man, Frank Vinci, the most influential gangster in Empire Bay. Vinci's blood is that of Sicily, his mob heritage going back to extortion in Italian lemon groves, but his heart now beats in America. He will never relinquish the old ways. In fact, he's the primary evidence that they still work. Vinci, dude. Lou Marcano, dude. New Bordeaux hype. New Bordeaux. Those of a timid disposition read no further. There are women in New Bordeaux of doubtful reputation, and Lou Marcano is their keeper. A pimp. A fiend. A threat to marriage, overweight, overbearing, and overzealous. He and his brothers now hold the city in their thrall. The death of Giuseppe Carillo has left the bayou in disarray, and the power it grants to Lou Marcano will make all proud women folk weep. Dude, Mafia 3 is dope, but not the best. Lincoln Clay chat, shout out. Why am I going back here, dude? Fuck! I'm sorry. Excuse me.
Where the hell are you?
Oh. I gotta remember the controls, chat. Crouch. Run. Aim.
Hey, buddy. Jesus.
Drop your weapon.
You first.
We don't have time for this. Sorry, pal. Guess we're doing this the hard way.
Okay, then.
Get over here! I got him pinned down!
Blast him!
You know how to use that thing? Son of a...
Shit. Tommy gun. Oh, it's all right. Heal up. Ibraco, wait, 66 months. My bro, dude, it was jolly. Jolly as hell. So jolly.
Wow! Me, Tom.
Polly, what took you so long?
Looking for Sammy. Did you find him?
Not yet. Just him.
Canadian crew. Dollars to donuts to rest the face down in the dirt, too. Oh, Christ.
Sketch.
They're cops, Tommy.
Well, how would I know? They didn't show a badge. Didn't say anything.
They must be in Morello's pocket. This bastard. He can't even let us have this one racket.
Morello.
Forget about it, Tom. We gotta find Sam and get out of here.
How's the volume check? How's that audio check? Everything good?
What is it, Tom? Doing this or what?
These guys are the real deal. They gotta be cops from the Border Patrol.
Excellent.
They've come heavy, all right. Make Lost Heaven PD look like pussycats.
Tommy gun chat. So, Mafia.
Okay, we search the farm, find Sam, get the hell out. Anyone else? We slip him the bump.
Slip him the bump. Canadian passport. Joseph Tremblay, bottler, Winnipeg, Canada, October 6th, 1899. Shout out to Arthur Morgan. Nice, Clayton. Sick. Winnipeg bootleggers, dude. Let's go, Clayton. Winnipeg bootleggers. Friggin' sick. Chat, we need a straight up. I'm not even joking right now. We need a straight up button check. Only because I looked at the Molotovs and I really want to know how to throw those. R1. Alright, it's R1. That's what I thought. Cross button, dude, cover. Cool. Cool. I really like the audio during the pause screen. It's so intense for no reason. It's like really intense. Someone was in a mood when they made it. Not quite as good as an Ellie or Abby takedown, but still good, but still good. Border Patrol orders, George. I have it on good authority that Salieri's whiskey handover is tonight. Our mutual friend wants this line of Canadian booze coming into the city shut down. I want you and your men at the farm we discussed by 9 p.m. Wait through the night and tell the boys it's fine if things get rough. They can take some hooch home to thank them for coming so far south. Good hunting. My next beer league hockey team, Winnipeg Bootleggers. Clayton, that's excellent. Hubert, did you play the Sly Cooper games? I just finished the second one, and I honestly think it's better than most of the Ratchet and Crash Bandicoot games. I finished the first one, Rayman, but as we always joke around, Ratchet and Clank, Jack and Daxter, and Sly Cooper. Very, very hard to have played all three of those franchises. If you have, I salute you, but I personally was Jack and Daxter and Ratchet, so I only played the first Sly through completion. Gotta play the next ones, though. Still have it on my forever backlog. Ridiculous. But that's a Brad joint. Talked to Brad Ellis about Sly. He's pleased every time he gets off on it chat. He wants you to ask him about Sly Cooper. Brad wakes up every morning hoping somebody references Sly Cooper.
Yeah, border cops doing Morello's dirty work.
Detective Comics, see what we got. Love these. An Inspector Allhoff story. Weather fair, track bloody. Love them. These are all so freaking good. This one's so dope. Love this. I want to play this game, chat. I want to play this game. Right now. Right now, I want to play this video game. Whatever it is. Happy murder to you. Death is from hunger. Some dude handcuffed and roped to the back of a car while this woman is ducked down, searching in her purse and firing a freaking 45. What is this? This is the game I want to play. My goodness. Ones. Yeah, it's good. It's good. It's good. It's a good place to hide diamonds. This one's fucking intense. Out of control. Out of control. Dope. Dope. Death wears red heels, dude. Death wears red heels. Live and let die. Combined with Flynn's detective fiction, dude. Some like crossover event, chat. Some crossover issue. Too good. Too good. Yo, everyone's chilling. Waiting on Tommy's move. Don't even trip. This is not good. Where's my backup, chat? My goodness. The F? They did not have my back there. That was unfortunate. Yo, I just want to feel 47 right now. I just want to feel him. I want to feel Hitman. 47. I want to just pretend to dump a body in a back room chat. I just want to pretend. Just for a second. Right here. Some little back corner. Yo, that DLC mission's coming soon. Finally, dude. New Hitman level. It's been so long. Just give me a level. Just give me one level, Io. That's it. Just one. My goodness. See, one. It's coming. Coming. Oh, health, health, health. Oh, it's on the inside. It's on the other side. Yeah, how does this always happen? Oh my god. There's always some insane botch, dude. Some like insane whoops. What? Oh, get it out of the way. Get it out of the way. There we go. Nice save. Nice checkpoint. Generous. Farm sale poster, public sale. Following the seizure of Cope's farm and the foreclosure of the business of J. Smith and Son by the Grand Imperial Bank, Lost Heaven assets we be sold at public auction on Tuesday. We be sold. Chad, do you think moving forward, what do you think? Video game moment. Oh, excuse me. Should I had some spicy nachos earlier, chat, and I did not swallow it good. I did not swallow those spicy nachos. They were insane. I'm still feeling it. Still feeling it. Okay. Do you think... It wasn't too... It was just before this stream started. So like an hour ago. Do you think... Collectibles... should ever be during a mission? Do you think it's a case-to-case basis? Because isn't it always weird, like, stopping to pick up a collectible mid-mission? What do you think? So it's on the type of game, for sure. It's always weird, you know? It's always weird being in, like, a intense firefight. You know? and then like picking something up, and it's like pause. Pause while this super intense firefight is going on. It's a little weird. I don't know. But yeah. I'm eager to see the continued evolution of collectibles in video games, chat. As the games come out and the years go by, you know, what it means to be a collectible. Sam! Oh! Oh shit. It's just fun using a Tommy gun in a game, chat. It's just like such a specific,
thank Christ,
iconic weapon.
You boys stay here and watch our backs. Plug anyone who gets within 100 yards. Except us.
Okay, just hang on. I'll go get the truck, then we'll take you to the doctor. Hey, you're gonna make it, Sam. Tommy, stay here with him. I'll be back in a flash.
Okay.
Fuck!
Bum, 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 bum. Classic Mafia.
Hey, it'll be okay, Sam. We survived worse.
You sure we have?
Oh!
Where did all these guys come from? time.
Jesus. Richard Harrow! Get a rifle. Right here and ammo? Shit. Holy shit! Hey, dude! It's too intense! Chat, I'm so... Chat, I don't know why the hell I'm used to... It's because of Red Dead. It's because of fucking Red Dead. R1 cover, dude. R1 cover. R1 cover. R1 cover. Pop, 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 pop. That's it, dude. That's it. The cross video game streams, dude. The controls. They don't play well with others. Aww. Sorry, we're in the zone now. Maybe. Sick. Fuck 'em. You'll never take me alive.
Christ. Tony and Donnie too?
Yeah.
What a fucking massacre. How's Sam?
Well, he ain't any worse.
I'll go get him. Keep an eye out.
I think bullet train will be in here. I think it could be okay. It's not gonna be amazing. Hopefully it's okay and good. Hopefully. Kind of a coin flip.
Okay. Hey, we're gonna get you all patched up. Okay?
We got more company.
Yeah, it should be a good time.
Get in.
I'm pumped to see it. I want to see it in a rowdy theater.
There's some ammo and a Thompson back there somewhere. When they pull in behind you, blast them to hell. Just don't let them get past us.
Intense right now. What the hell? Always forget about this. Okay. I need to turn. Whoa. That was weird. The fuck? That was so weird. Yeah, on classic, dude. That's why I didn't want to. I toned it down. I don't want to do it. Let me turn that down a bit. It's out of control. Yeah, I like my low sensitivity, Jet.
That thing back there is huge.
Still too intense. Yeah, I got to see the north one with Brad, so it was a good time. I don't often see movies with Brad. Only because I see a shitload of movies. So it averages out to not that many. Like a millisecond away from this last time, chat. Damn.
Did we lose them?
Two squad cars on us.
Some Last of Us shit right there with the death animations, dude. The like death, the game over. Oh my god, that was violent. Jeez. Yo, so is Resident Evil out, chat? Because I was gone. Probably watch that tonight. That's cool. Don't tell me. I don't even want to know your opinion. Whoa. 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 I just went to IMDb, though. That was a mistake. Whoa. So, GameSpot gives it a 9, and IMDb gives it a 3.4. I'll let you know, chat. I'll give it a watch. It seems divisive. Wow. So out of control. We're not gonna make it. Okay. Yo, Indiana Jones vibes. So unhinged. Shit. Yeah, is this Uncharted, chat? Dude, I remember this on Classic being the most annoying shit, dude. Thank God. Oh, good. Good, good. We're not on Classic, chat. We made the right decision. We absolutely made the right decision. You cannot miss. You cannot miss. You cannot miss. It's out of control, man. You cannot miss. This thing wasn't the original. It was. Not a lot of liberties in this remake. Turret, it's hard, it's hard. I gotta turn the sensitivity down even a little more. It's brutal. Yeah, I need the mouse. I need the mouse on this. Get that mouse hooked up. Bum, bum, bum. Alright. We'll get it. don't even think it matters, does it? There it is. Not gonna make it. Shoot the turret. I'm trying. It's so hard. The reload is brutal. It's brutal. Chat, if this was on Classic, it would take... Dude, chat, I was offended. Chat, from lock, dude. I'm sitting... in a restaurant. And Kate Bush comes on the speakers, dude, loud enough. And I just go, Vecna! Nobody looks. Nobody says anything. Dude, the reload. Hold it steady, Polly. It's tough, chat. It's tough. It's a Stranger Things reference. So if you watch Stranger Things. So good, dude. What? We had so many hits. What in the world? All right. Yeah, it really has to be perfect. It does. It's annoying. You know, we control our own... Dude, chat, we can put it on easy for this. We don't even care. No. Oh my gosh, Resident Evil 5, the freaking El Gigante relegated to a turret boss fight. That's a bummer in 5. But it makes sense. I mean, turret, whether you like it or not, turret sections were a big deal at the time. And... yeah, no, I can't defend it. Co-op El Gigante would have been sick. You know? Said you just have miniguns? That was every bullet hit. Not good. Okay. Turn it down, don't care. What's the point? I got nothing to prove. Do you care, chat? Do you care? Am I less of a gamer, chat? Oh yeah, easy mode. Oh yeah. Still not gonna get it. Oh, even on easy. It's ridiculous. Yeah, it's not even fun. It's not fun. Numbers were crunched here. What is this Guardian Ape shit? The world?
Doing here so late?
Sorry to wake you, but we had a little accident. We got an injured man out here.
All right, bring him inside.
Okay, thank you. Okay, I'll stay with Sam. You can take the truck back. Call it a night.
No, I'll wait.
The doc's already got his hands full. No sense in both of us breathing down his neck.
Go on, Tom. We'll be fine. Okay.
Hey. You did good tonight.
Shipment. Oh my gosh, Bakhtan, yeah. I love butcher dude with the bag. Oh. Alright, turn it back up. We can handle it. Joe, is audio doing something weird for you? Yeah, what? Game audio died. I hear him breathing.
Presidential address delivered earlier this year on the topic of the National Recovery Administration. This is part of our series looking back over the president's plans and results since his inauguration.
While we are making this great common effort, there should be no discord and no dispute. This is no time to cavil or to question the standards set by this universal agreement. It is time for patience and understanding and cooperation. The workers of this country have rights under this law, which cannot be taken from them, and nobody will be permitted to whittle them away.
It's so weird.
But, on the other hand, no aggression is necessary to attain those rights.
But Rudy only is sick.
The whole country will be united to get them for you. The principle that applies to the employers applies to the workers as well. And I ask you workers to cooperate in the same spirit. When Andrew Jackson, Old Hickory, died, someone asked, will he go to heaven? The answer was, he will if he wants to. If I am asked whether the American people will pull themselves out...
Oh, shit, it's an accident.
Will if they want to. The essence of the plan is a universal limitation of hours of work per week for any individual by common consent, and a universal payment of wages above the minimum, also by common consent. My friends, I cannot guarantee the success of this nationwide plan.
It's so weird, chat. Isn't it crazy?
People of this country.
It's all messed up.
Its success. I have no faith in cure-alls, but I believe that we can greatly influence economic forces. I have
run
no
very fast
with the professional economists who insist that things must run their course and that human agencies can have no influence on economic ills. One reason.
Alright, I can't do this. That one, I don't like. It's freaking me out. It's freaking me out, dude. Economic wills. I don't give a shit. Holy shit. We're on the wrong side of the road. We're on the right side of the road, chat. We're unhinged. Music, though. Yep. This is the jam right here.
Broadcasting live from Behringer's Department Store, this is WBDS. Stay with us for more music.
This car is wrecked. Absolutely wrecked. Whoa! Alright, chat, hope it works. Did it work?
You're late. Dinner's cold.
Work.
Sketch. She knows. Her dad was a stone cold killer. Good shot. They expanded her role in the remake, if any. Like, that's what they... Nothing else has really changed too much. I definitely gave Sarah a little more, which I appreciate. This scene is still, though, like, in it. So everything is just a little more expanded.
Marry me.
Okay.
Weird. It happens like that, though, I guess. You can go down like that. There we are. Whatever. What? Omerta. Chat, look up Omerta right now. The code, dude. Mafia code.
It came as soon as I got your message.
Sit down, Tom. We have a mole.
Mole!
No. Who?
I was up all night driving myself nuts trying to figure it out. Started thinking maybe it's one of our guys. We aren't paying his fair share. Someone with a light wallet.
Someone with a light
maybe
wallet.
Looking to Marilla for a new suit. Frank wasn't around, so I went to the safe to get the account books. To see who's getting cents on the dollar he's earned.
What do you know?
The books are gone.
Shit.
Frank.
More than 50 years I've known him. Everything I have, I got with Frank. And every buck we've earned, every dime we've paid out, it's all logged in those books. Frank hands those over to the feds, we're finished.
Frank respects one person in this whole town, and that's you. This has got to be some kind of misunderstanding.
I've been calling him all day. I went by his place. He's gone. His wife and kid are gone.
But why?
I don't know. I'm sure he has his reasons. Maybe he's still smarting over the dog.
The one you tried to drown.
Yeah. Same one I shot after he wouldn't let me sink her. I was a stupid kid, Tommy. But grudge or no grudge, we gotta get those books back. Shake down all our stoolies. See you in our
stoolies. Book. Stool pigeon.
You get those books. And if he doesn't have them on him, you make him tell you where to find them. After that, you do what we gotta do.
Sick.
Vincenzo's waiting for you with a clean car.
Audio, dude. Alright, we gotta reload, Jack. We gotta reload this shit. We gotta bounce out. Jeez. Austin says, I know GTA can be wacky sometimes. I wish we could get something that has a very serious tone like Mafia. That's why I like Red Dead so much. Because it gets so serious. I like when GTA does get serious, so it's always, like, so earned. When GTA gets fucking serious. Yes. Yes. Yes, God. Nico Bellic. Nico Bellic. Dude, just bring Nico Bellic back for 6. I don't care. Do it. Do it. I will lose my shit, dude. He doesn't need to be the main character, dude. I'm not saying that. I'm not saying GTA 6 needs to be like Nico playable main. But like, dude, just get him involved in there. Just get him in there, dude. Shit. That would suck, Nemo. I don't think they would ever do that. They would never do it to Nico. They would never, ever dare. I mean, it's Rockstar, so you never know. That'd be so dumb, though. That'd be so stupid. That'd be so stupid.
Senzo's waiting for you with a clean car.
Chad, what's going on here? Game is glitched out, chat. Game is
tough day today,
glitched out. Glitched out game. Wow. Alright, chat, give me a second. Give me a moment. For pity's sake. You know, everything sounds kind of weird, dude. It's like my PlayStation freaked out. Hey, maybe it's busted, chat. We'll see how. We'll get a restart. Just doing a restart. Hope you're having a good time tonight, chat. Hope you're having a great night. Chad, I want to be at the craps tables with you. What's wrong with you right now? Should be good. You definitely cannot have cell phones around. Like, dude, gotta have good etiquette. Gotta have good etiquette at the tables. Dude, there's so many stories, Chad. There's so many stories, dude. It's one night of craps, dude. Oh my god. Out of control, dude. Out of control. The dealers, dude. We were just, like, betting for the dealers. This dealer named Khan was the best. He kept trolling us. Because I'm, like, kind of noob, too, you know? Like, sometimes I would, like, make mistakes. I would just be like, yo, can I raise here? Like, you know? And they would just joke around with us, dude. And we were just, like, throwing bets everywhere for them, dude. It was such good vibes. Loved it. Just that feeling when somebody's rolling, dude. The whole table is like going berserk. The best. The best. All the dealers. Dude, the dealers kept doing this sick thing where one of the guys kept like catching the chips in like different ways. Khan would like throw them up. And then he'd be like, boom. It's awesome. It's good vibes.
Vincenzo's waiting for you with a clean car.
Everyone was just having a good night. Everyone was just friendly, chat. It was just good vibes. And it gave me hope. You know?
Tough day.
We gotta keep
Tom.
A lid on this, Tom. Start with Biff, but don't give him nothing. I got your clean set of wheels. And something special here, if you want it.
Vincenzo. Sawed off. Look at this.
Season Lapara. You'll know.
The Lupara lore. Omerta. Dude, love this spot, chat. Cool spot. Little diner, dude. Reminds you of Boardwalk Empire, chat. Yes, dude. Fucking hell. Bone for tuna. The hell does that mean? Oh my goodness. You know, magazine over here? Did we miss one? Nice. Death gives a permanent wave. Look at her handing him the gun. Is that what's going down? Sick. Jip Rosetti, Sweet Johnny Cage. Jip Rosetti. Oh my god, Jip Rosetti. Trolley hype.
And now for the latest news. The Navy is today continuing its search for the remains of those brave souls lost aboard the airship USS Akron.
Akron.
The Akron was destroyed in a violent thunderstorm off a New Jersey coast Tuesday morning with the loss of 73 of 76 aboard. The disaster stands as the worst aviation accident on record. Yesterday, one of the survivors, Lieutenant Commander Herbert V. Wiley, spoke to members of the press and gave a brief account of the tragedy. He also spoke of the survivors' rescue by the German tanker, Phoebus. President Roosevelt has described the loss of the Akron as a national disaster and said that he grieves with the wives and families of those lost and the nation. We will bring you more on the disaster and the Navy's search as we receive it. Thank you for listening.
Sick. Looks like Babe Ruth, chat. I know, Modest Mime. I don't like to test it. Just chilling. Sometimes I open it up, as you've seen earlier.
Tommy, what's the rumpus?
Whoever sent me that video on Twitter, thank you. That bear dude coming in? It's nutso.
Heard any big news lately? Something that Don might want to know.
It depends. What's it worth to you?
$20.
How about 40?
All right, spill.
The FBI's in town. They're getting something from Morello, but I don't know what.
How'd you hear?
Little Tony got some guy drunk in the Black Cat and drove him home. Heard a bunch of stuff, so he's the guy you want to see.
Okay. Thanks.
Little Tony.
Always a pleasure, Tommy.
Dude, Kingdom video game chat, so hyped. Even if it's only PC mobile, you know, it's probably gonna be pretty low budget, but whatever. We need a Warriors video game next. Or Warrior, I mean. Not Warriors. There are still speakeasies, Modest Man. Sports Report. Pause. There's speakeasies. Like, LA has speakeasies. It's called a speakeasy, go down a thing, and there's, like, a secret door. But it's still, like, it's not really, but it is, you know? Honestly, a thing closer to a speakeasy to me was when I was in Iceland, chat. I ate in this restaurant, and within the restaurant, so you go in the restaurant, and then within that restaurant, there's like a back secret door that goes into like a Michelin star restaurant. Like, chef and like six people, that's it. Like, intimate. It was cool. Damn, I bet that's really good food back there. Yeah, Spectron, Damiani and I are going to stream it at some point. So says I. It's one of my favorites. I really love it. Yo, am I allowed to post, like, some Stranger Things images? Like, I still just wanted to post one thing from that season. That's it. Just one image. And it's not Vecna. It's just one character doing something. That's all. It is someone with a something. All right, chat, BRB, give me a minute. Yeah, I had it all copied and ready to go. Copied, ready to paste it. You know, ready to go, dude. I'm in the spoiler thread. I do not have permission to send messages in this channel chat, dude. I don't have permission. So I can't do it. That's what it says. So that spoiler will have to remain in my brain. But it's a good one, dude. It's a good one.
A sense of anticipation as we await the start of the big game.
Yo, game five.
Lost Heaven Lancers are out on the road, deep in enemy territory as they take on bitter rivals, the Empire Bay
Cannons. Empire Bay Cannons.
The Gold Series is shaping up to be one of the best on record, with both teams matching one another below
the blow. That's true.
Despite the Cannons' home field advantage and an early lead in the series, the Lancers have bounced back and have really taken their rivals to task. Many of the plaudits and column inches have been dedicated to one man. Lancers pitcher Buddy Smith is one of this year's standout performers. And with this series tied at 3-3, he may well be the key man that brings the Wispman Trophy back to Lost Heaven. But doing so will
Lost Heaven versus Empire Bay, dude, World Series.
Captain Foghorn, Jack Seidel. His solo home run in the bottom of the fifth inning of Game 5 turned events in favor of the Empire Bay team.
Love this broadcast, chat. Love this.
Or will the Cannons' towering redhead have the final say? WLH 570 Lost Heaven Radio will carry live coverage of the final game of the Gold Series, and we hope you'll join us in wishing our boys well. And now, back to some of the latest musical numbers.
Sick. Hell yeah, dude. Come on, my... Fuck. Modest mind, dude. I still listen to baseball on the radio, personally. So. It's not that crazy. Or I'm just a freaking old soul. I'm an old soul. I'm an old soul. There we go. I have access. Here we go. There it is. It's culmination, chat. That's it. That's everything, chat. That's it. Obsessed. Thank you, Gary. Perfect. You're not done, dude. It's perfect. Oh! That was immediate. Perfect. We got there in like less than 2 minutes. Yo, look at this bar, chat. Look at this vibe right here. Yeah, Gabby for the win, chat. If Gabby wasn't here. No spoiler. Everyone thank Gabby right now. Everyone thank Gabby. Round of applause for Gabby. Yeah, dude, it's the best. It's the best. Every time I think of that image, chat, it just makes me want to run it all back. All of it. Just run it back.
Everything okay, Tom?
Hell yeah, everything's alright. Go get 'em, boys! Yeah, we just heard about this on the radio, chat! It's a big deal. Game 7 of the 1933 Gold Series today. The Lost Heaven Lancers play the Empire Gate. And they gave us a little pregame there about the pitchers. Lost Heaven Lancers. Lost Heaven Lancers play the Empire Bay Cannons at the Armory, with one team certain to take home the trophy. After a heroic campaign filled with exhilarating twists... Oh my god, I have another Vegas story, chat. A good one. Filled with exhilarating twists, Captain Bunny Smith will lead his men onto the diamond to play for the Lancers' first series victory in over 2 decades. They need this win. So, chat... Obviously, I love the Dodgers. This is a custom Dodgers shirt. Obviously, I love the Dodgers. I'm in Vegas. Dodgers are playing the Angels. I'm like, dude. Quick bet on that. My buddy's like, yo, you're betting on the Dodgers? I'm betting on the Dodgers. My other friend is like, Yo, you guys are betting on the Dodgers? I'm betting on the Dodgers. Dodgers win. Dodgers win. Watching it. Dude, Kershaw almost had a perfect game, chat. Were you watching? Holy shit. Again. So nuts. It's really sad, though, chat. Kershaw had a perfect game, and I shit you not. This is not a lie. This is not even an exaggeration at all. No hyperbole. No hype. Kershaw's pitching a perfect game, which there's been like 30 of in like 100,000 games of baseball, by the way. Like the history of baseball, there's been like 30 total. He has a perfect game. The very second I tweet it, he gives up a hit. I didn't tweet that he has a perfect game. I just tweeted that I was watching the game. You don't mention it, of course. There was no mention of it, but I still felt partially responsible. It felt horrible. I was like, oh my god. Kershaw, dude, I'm sorry, Kershaw. Yo, this one. Yo, it's a science one. No, terror. Terror Tales. Two strongly contrasted novelettes of unusual terror. Mistress of the Dark Pool. Test Tube Frankenstein. So creep. Some creepy vibes right here. Look at this, like, Book of Cagliostro this guy's got. Look at this. This guy's up here, like, drinking blood or something. Some blood concoction. This is some bioweapon shit right here. Sirens. Mermaid sirens.
Nah, it's not. What's this about the guy you drove home who's with the feds?
He came in for a drink, which turned into 10. He's hired muscle for some kind of safe house.
Where?
Oakhill. Corner of
Oakhill.
He gave me $10 to drive him back and keep my mouth shut. That arm, that Councillor Gilatti's, brokered some kind of deal between Morello and the FBI. They were all ready to sit tight on someone in there.
Why the hell didn't you tell us?
Tom, I did. I came in to see Frank straight away. He didn't tell the Don?
No, he didn't.
Tom? What's going on?
What's going on, dude? Something's going down, chat. It's a rat.
We return now to the coverage of Game 7 of the Gold.
Game 7!
And by the looks of it, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be underway any minute now. The crowd here in the Armory are restless. You can almost taste the tension as we approach this, the deciding game between these two famous rivals. More than a little bad blood between them and more than a couple of nasty flare-ups in recent years. Of course, this occasion, more than any other, could prove feisty. What with the drama that closed out the previous game. That, of course, saw the Lancers win to tie the series, and it's not often Empire Bay and Lost Heaven can boast the game's best current hitter and pitcher, respectively. I refer, of course, to Foghorn Seidel, a man mountain with a shock of red hair, and Lancers star Bunny Smith. Speaking of Smith, he is jogging, I suppose you'd say, between his teammates, issuing last-minute orders. They seem responsive to whatever he's saying. He commands respect from his team, that is for sure. My goodness, there must be some nerves among some of the younger Lancers, Elms, Graveson, and Nicholson. Smith seemed to have pepped them up. That's good to see. That's what a good captain does. The Cannons lineup is meandering over to the home team dugout. The Lancers are slowly taking up their position, so we can't be too far away from the opening pitch here at the Armory, the home of the Empire Bay Cannons. Stay with us for more.
Sick, dude. Still pregame.
The mission of Lost Heaven Radio, our city's public service broadcaster.
Hell yeah, I'm gonna see Nope in the IMAX. 100%. It's an IMAX joint. Got to.
For the latest technological innovations and labor-saving devices, Behringer's is the place to visit. Cutting-edge radio sets, vacuum cleaners, dryers, and more are waiting for you to try them. Make your life easier with a visit to Behringer's Department Store. This is WBDS, broadcasting live from Behringer's.
Like the place.
Nice house. I remember this. I remember this in the original chat vividly. Final play already? Too fast.
A quick reminder that this final inning is being brought to you by...
Should have been like the sixth.
When you need a lift, reach for a Swift. It's not only a taste sensation, it's guaranteed to increase focus, drive, and mental clarity. Pick up a bottle of Swift Cola today. And as we are coming to a close, let me thank today's other sponsors. Big Break Cigarettes and Lost Heaven Courier. Both of these teams could be said to be entering golden eras. Each team has a star player at the core with promising youngsters set around them. I refer, of course, to Smith and Seidel. The Cannons have had several such golden periods. The Lancers, it's fair to say, have not. I can see Lancers manager Frankie Hodge prowling in front of the dugout, gesticulating. He seems animated, to say the least. Looks like he's putting one of the officials in his place or something or other. With the noise of the crowd, it is quite hard to say for sure. Whatever's going on down there, you can feel the sense of occasion, and you just know that whatever happens, the crowd will be the first to tell you what has happened. The Lancers are now within minutes of snatching the gold series, which at one stage had appeared doomed, but they equally teeter on the edge of defeat. It all comes down to the final play. Nobody is warming up in the
bullpen.
Gotta
be some kind of meat.
Nobody down there is considering the possibility of extra innings. Bunny Smith then, standing on the mound, a look of steely determination on his face. He's betraying no emotion, doesn't look nervous or tired after his exertions this series, nor does he appear to be carrying the weight of expectation. He's having a word with the umpire about something.
Such a good announcer, dude. My God.
If the Lancers are to win here today, he's going to write.
Can this guy be the Dodgers?
And boy, oh boy,
love Joe Davis.
Mean to the people of Lost Heaven.
Love Stein.
Such a long time without glory on the diamond. All right, they've sorted out whatever was going on. Here we go then. In for the Cannons, it's Paddy Dougherty. Smith is pitching the game of his life, but Dougherty's a big man. If he can catch one, it could run, and with bases loaded, the Cannons would have it. Here we go. Dougherty facing down Smith. Pass ball and strike. The big man.
Shit. They're taking you to the airport, Frank.
My goodness. It's fair to say Dougherty looks a little spooked. He was convinced he had it. His body language tells the tale. Smith remains cool under pressure, not a flicker of emotion on his face. He winds up. And that's two. There was zip on that one. Good Lord. Seidel is barking something at Dougherty, but we have no chance of hearing it as the noise of the crowd reaches fever.
So epic.
Dougherty's gesturing, and that's only making Seidel more irate. This is it, folks. Another strike, and the Lancers win. If Dougherty can get behind it, surely the Cannons will get all their men home and snatch victory. A swing and a miss, and that's the winners! Lancers win! Lancers win! And Smith finally cracks an elated smile. He's thrown his cap in the air, as have his teammates. Lancers win the 1933 Gold Series!
So epic, dude. Cut to commercial. Still awesome, dude. Still awesome. So awesome. They added that. Jolly, like, jazz music like this in the original, of course.
Fuck, this ain't good.
Oh, shit. Weird. A lot of little issues. They have some classic songs. They have some classic songs, Gabby, in the original. Like, maybe I'm thinking of two as well. They do have some classic stuff. Super jolly. Love it. Informant handover. We shut down airport. Informant and FBI escort leave safe house. Informant exchange and taken to Hangar 5. Hangar 5. Classic video game right here.
Why'd the feds take charge here?
Oh shit, I waited too long. Punch him out! Bum, bum, bum. Oh shit.
On his side! Get to his side! On him!
High ground, chat. Such dramatic. Dude, the music. It reminds me of Batman animated series. It really does. Like, Batman is throwing a batarang right now, chasing down some thugs. Do not have a range here. Oh my goodness. Sniper somewhere. It's not good. I got two shotguns. As I usually end up with, you know, one way or another, chat. Two shotguns. Who is blasting away out here? Above? Oh, and out, and out. Thank you. Oh god. Dude, double kill, chat. Oh! Ha, ha. So intense. It's alright. I botched it. I was trying to just like talk about something. I was trying to talk about just stealth in video games. 76 months. Erebus Wolf, love and respect. Yeah, you definitely need 3 shotguns. Yo, I appreciate how that cop spotted us, chat. That was pretty good. He was just like, oh, you know, it's good. I appreciate it. Oh, here we go. Oh, hello. Can I pick this up? There we go. Oh! Oh god. Oh god! It's a botch. It's kinda like choppier and oh god. Oh my god, chat. It's too intense. Settle down. This guy's squirrely! A freak! That guy. Aiming is rough. You know? It just is. You know, we're not Abby Anderson right now, chat. We're not Abby Anderson. Alright. Wait. Just let me hit the gun first. Game. Gun. Yep. There we go. Dude, choppy. Chop. Fuck. Yeah, but we're already saved to, we already got caught, because we were fooling around. We're at a checkpoint, so, yeah. Oh yeah, we did get the checkpoint and we were safe. But this one's for you, Bossman. Wherever you are. I know you like sniping. I know you like popping those headshots with a sniper rifle. He appreciates it. Doing, dude. Oh, I saw that. Notice all staff. The request of the FBI, all flights are suspended. Normal service will resume once their operation has ended. Please keep passengers at a safe distance from the airport. Private aircraft, dude. Hangar 5. We gotta take Hangar 5. That's where I need to get to. Probably next time if we die, we'll be a little more stealthy. Dude, the music is so intense. It puts me on edge in a good way. Like, my energy is heightened. Oh, shit! It kind of reminds me of Phantom Pain. That mission, dude, with all the hangers. Or no, is that Peace Walker? No, it's Phantom Pain. Yeah, rescuing Huey, dude. Sweet Johnny Cage knows what's up. Yes. What's up? This Warner Brothers lot. Got me, dude. Oh, fuck. Don't botch this. Oh, fuck! Where'd these guys come from? I thought we had it. I don't even know what took us out in the end. It felt like somebody threw like a rock at us, and that's how we died. That's the feedback I got as a player. Somebody threw a rock, dude, just like pop. What? Oh, we're dead. It's weird. Alright, we're gonna be stealth now. We're gonna try to at least. Bum 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 bum. Do that OG theme remix. It's good. It's good. It's excellent. All that, dude, just remixing all, it's so good. Alright, let's not set ourselves on fire, chat. Saw me. I botched the chat. Maybe, dude. Maybe we can, like, sneak out here. Can't see me, dude. Can't see me. Shit. We might be able to cross over the next fence. No, we can't. We can't. It's too high. Ba-ba-ba. Batarang, dude. Oh shit, this is where we died last time. I'm already throwing Molotovs accidentally, dude. It begins.
Tom.
Frank. The Don sent me.
I figured as much. I'm sorry it had to be you, Tommy.
Anything you want me to tell him?
I wish it could have shaken out better, but Morello finally came after me. It's okay. You can come out. Morello offered me a simple trade. The Don's account books for our
simple trade
and tickets out of this town.
You hand the books over yet?
I'm not so stupid, Don. They're safe. Morello was waiting for this.
It's a key to a box in the Grand Imperial Bank.
Bank!
I told Morello I'd hand it over after the plane was fueled and ready to go. His men were meant to fetch it before we left.
I took care of them. Told them to get on a plane.
Go on, March, Alice. Get aboard.
Frank, you're coming with us.
Not right now, honey. Just get buckled in. Tommy and I, we have some serious business to discuss.
But Frank...
Get on the plane, March. For Alice. For me. Get on the goddamn plane, please.
You been paid yet?
Yeah.
Now you've been paid twice. You take the ladies wherever they want to go.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Tom.
Christ, Frank. Why didn't you ask us for help?
I guess I just wanted out. One way or the other. I'm tired, Tommy. Tired of lying to my wife. Tired of checking under my car every time I take a Sunday drive. And tired of waiting for the Don to put two in my temple.
Damn you, Frank.
No way, dude. No way you pulled the trigger here, dude. I did the same thing in Red Dead, the RP there. With the mayor. I let his buddy go. Mayor orders the hit. I'm like, dude, get out of here. No way. Arthur would be licking his lips If you could pull it off, dude. I'm terrible at it.
Hey there, sweetie.
How you doing?
I'm gonna perfect the standard bank heist in Red Dead chat. Once I beat it, we'll just stream non-stop bank robberies. Just non-stop. Just bank. Hitting all the banks, dude, in one day.
Where's the safety deposit boxes?
With my colleague downstairs, sir.
Thanks.
I need to see the manager.
He's not here today, sir. Can I help?
No! No, you can't!
That's all you got. Where's he going? Where's he going? Is he going to see the manager? Is he walking out? Where's he going? To stew in the corner. He's going to stare out the window. The manager won't see me.
Beautiful day, huh?
Uh-huh.
Out of trouble, I hope.
Trip to the country. Muddy, bloody mayhem in the boondocks with our beloved bootleggers. Tight. So cool.
Need to access the deposit boxes for Frank Coletti.
Yes, Mr. Angelo?
Yeah.
Mr. Coletti said it might be you who came, and to provide access. Please, follow me.
It's good foresight, Frank.
Got the books and covered my tracks. Salieri never asked any questions. In fact, apart from the funeral, I never heard him talk about Frank
Savage.
Again.
Savage.
Making my boys twitchy, Marco.
Sergio and I just came by to pay respects, that's all. Known Frank a long time. Almost as long as you. He's a good man. Smart. Loyal. Loyal to his wife. His kid above all else. There must be some kind of honor in that, in you.
Maybe. But I'm still looking at this headstone with his little girl's name on it.
Hell of a thing.
Class. classic, yeah. Classic mob funeral standoff. It's classic. Dude, I love the Watchmen funeral. It's a good one. But Snyder. Snyder loves umbrellas, I feel like. Sarah, what's up? It was good vibes. It was such good vibes. It was great. It's a great time. It's a great time. Chad, we are gonna crunch. We'll do one more mission. One more. And I'll be right back, alright? Be right back for the crunch. Get your research in, get your snacks ready. I'll be right back. Seems like it's time for an intermission coming up. I wonder. I hope so. I'm glad people are playing Mafia. It's good. It's good vibes. No, absolutely not. Rage roll. Probably should just part ways. No disruptions. Yo, Yankees Dodgers collision course, chat. Get ready. Absolute collision course. Yo, intermission. Gonna hit us. Hit us with it. Nope, visiting rich people. Good crunch, chat. Good crunch.
Look at these houses. Big yards, white picket fences. It's the American dream, eh, Tommy?
I suppose.
Not for you?
No, sir. I like being closer to the business.
Don't let the flower beds and front porches fool you. There's more criminals out here than in the rest of the city combined.
Are that why we're in the neighborhood?
In a way. Morell's got a dirty prosecutor on his payroll named Watkins. Turns out he's old friends with Galati.
The city councilor?
The same. Morell let drop that we might have had something to do with the Galati boy's death. Now Watkins is loaded for bear, trying to do right by his buddy. Word is, he's striking gold with a few witnesses.
You have names?
Yeah. Napoleon and Sam are taking care of them. I'm putting you on a different part of the job. We need whatever Watkins has got
on us. Watkins.
Well, where's he holding?
A safe in his villa.
I'm no safe cracker.
Don't worry about that. We're taking you to meet
Salvatore.
He's the boat, but he knows how to pop open anything. Just get him into the villa, find the safe, and he'll do the rest.
What kind of rumpus should I expect?
Nothing you can't handle. Watkins is going to the theater, so the house should be empty except for a bit of muscle. The office is on the first floor, and Arstuli says the safe is in the wall. Once Salvatore has the safe open, grab all the evidence and get out.
That him, boss?
Yeah, I'm always up, Tommy. When we go back decades.
Si, grazie. Don Salieri.
Good to see you. You know the job. Don't let me down.
Si. Ho capisco.
Tommy, if you bump into Watkins, don't kill him. It'll just bring down more heat.
You got it, boss.
Buona fortuna, ragazzi.
Bone for tuna. The hell does that mean? Ah, Jeff Rossetti.
Tommy Angelo. Piacere di conoscerti.
Meraviglioso.
Sick.
Per favore.
Love it, chat. Love it. Love Salvatore. Not love Salvatore. Hell yeah.
Parli almeno un po' di italiano? Il capo ti ha detto il piano?
I don't speak Italian.
Eccellente. Fantastico. No plan?
Yeah, the boss told me.
Please. Understand. Entriamo dal labirinto senza farci sentire né vedere. La cassaforte è dietro un dipinto al primo piano. Dammi un po' di tempo e lascia fare tutto a me. Quella cassaforte avrà sicuramente un allarme.
Yeah. This is gonna be a long night for the both of us.
Cristo Santo.
Okay, my
yeah, what were they saying, chat?
Do what I do. Do not get caught.
See,
you gotta keep safe.
Safe? See, it's my job. Apro cassaforte. Open safe.
Christ. Okay. Radio. Let's listen to the radio.
Eccellente.
Love it.
Hell of a view up here. A volte questo paese è stupendo.
It's a nice one. Good lord.
Ecco. Entriamo da lì.
Over. Wall. Labirinto.
What?
Vedrai.
Stay here while I take out the guards.
Per quanto pare, in America hanno il labirinto.
Choke him out. Choke him out, chat. One at a time. One at a time. Bum 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 bum.
I sure wish I could have a night off.
Got him good.
Someone in the maze with us!
What? Who saw me? Who saw me?
Sure wish I could have a night off.
Who saw us? Someone in the maze. Oh, it's that guy over there. Maybe he found a body. Could have found a body, maybe? Oh no. There it is. Dude, shotguns clashing, chat! Shotguns clashing, dude! What? What the hell, dude? They were treating that like they were lightsabers. Dude, Equilibrium, shout out. Super science. Prisoner of Time, a novel of tomorrow's destiny. Dude, look at that sketch alien in there. Hypnotizing. Look at this thing. So good, dude. It's haunting. This thing gives me the creeps. So good. So good. They're all so good. They're all so good. It's such a pleasure finding them. It's such a pleasure. Oh, shit. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. That's what the last two guys said. No! Oh, it's a botch. Last guy, chat. How brutal is that? How brutal is that? It's so brutal. Ugh. That was a 7 right there. We crap out. We just crapped out, chat. We just crapped out. House takes all the bets. All the bets. Everyone's just like, boom, 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 boom.
Stay here.
They just clean up, dude. It is such an image, chat. When someone craps out, dude, and you watch them just rake in the board. It's a sight to behold. Dude, craps, chat. I just want to play craps with you. Because you can play for cheap. You can play for legit, like, you can make it last. It's a, because each time, and you get to roll, chat. I'm there rolling the dice, dude. Like, chat, would you bet on me if I was rolling the dice? I'd feel so strong if we were there together. If we had our own table chat and we were all betting, rolling the dice, we'd clean them out. We'd clean them out. It's all a vibe, dude. It's all just a vibe. Because you got to play, it's not about the cash, ever. You never once think about that. Craps is awesome for just like the fucking bond, dude. The jolly communal vibes. It's like co-op. It's co-op gambling chat. It's straight up co-op. You're just chilling, dude. You just put like 10 bucks down. It lasts like a while, dude. You just, a little 10 bucks. You're like, all right, chill. Let's go.
Sure wish I could have a night off.
All these guys want nights off. I think they're overworked. But I'm not a professional, chat. I know the hard fundamentals. Hardcore fundamentals. Count me in. There's a couple things I still don't get. Something about the odds with like an even or odd, and you have to bet an even or odd, and you get like 6-5. Oh no. Shotguns clashing! It's so good.
Someone in the maze with us.
Oh! Sick shotgun CQC, chat. 10 out of 10. I'll give it a 10. I'll give the shotgun CQC top marks. This guy's gotta go. This guy crapped us out last time.
I think that's all of them.
Salvatore! Where are you? We're clear.
Tommy! I hear!
Where the hell did he go?
Sono qui, Tony!
Guy's a pain in the ass.
Forza! Vieni, con me! Tommy! I hear!
Sei un tipo tosto, eh?
What?
Ready, dude. Check the windows.
C'è un'entrata. Open. Kick.
What kind of luck picker are you?
Look for a dipinto.
What?
Da Vinci, Caravaggio, hai capito?
Painting? You're saying it's behind a paint? Okay. I understand.
Non quello.
Guess we got another room to check.
Love the language barrier. It's so good.
Here,
Empire Bay mob boss murdered. Empire Bay chat. Empire Bay chat. Picture right here, dude. It's crazy. Spectacular pictures of vile kingpins, fiery end, notorious racketeer, Tommaso Moretti was killed outside of his Empire Bay residence last Thursday afternoon, the sole victim of a car bomb undoubtedly planted by an underworld rival. Bay residents will hope that Moretti's death brings to an end the spat of gang violence that has rocked their city in recent months. Few will mourn his passing. Yeah. You're the crime in my coffee. Look at him getting the gun, dude. Love it. Love it. It's so good. It's a good one. Where is the trigger? Yeah, maybe it's behind her toe. It's behind her toe, probably. Still got a lot to go, chat. We have 40%, 0%, 15%, 5. Dude, only one of those. Gangster, dude. We got a lot to go. Love these. The most. Yo, we didn't check Sammy last time. New Bordeaux. Humble beginnings, a trait shared by so many powerful mobsters. Immigrants, orphans, the poor, and the destitute. Difficult circumstances that can create a thirst for something greater. Sammy Robinson is the son of a crippled sharecropper. He runs with the colored gangs in the swampy shanties of New Bordeaux. He wants a way up out of poverty. With time, he'll be a leader, and then with luck, he'll make it. Many, 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 many years later.
Only wall behind here.
Repent! America will not fall into temptation. Prohibition must be repelled. Do not get drunk on wine, which leads to debauchery. Instead, be filled with the Spirit. Ephesians 5:18. Boardwalk Empire chat.
Gotta be it.
Nope. Yo, kitchen? Jolly kitchen.
Another here, Salvatore.
Medicine room? This room's very Resident Evil. Get some, like, med up here. I like it. Whoa.
Ma'am! Someone help us!
Get out before things go bad for you.
Get out.
Nothing again.
Still no? Oh my goodness. The bitter end here, chat. The very last one. Oh, we gotta go up. Letter from Galati. Prosecutor Watkins, I am writing to thank you. If you can truly give us reliable witnesses, testimonies, and evidence that Salieri had Billy killed, I'll be in your debt. The priest's story never rang true, and now he's dead and buried. This feels like our last throw of the dice. The last throw of the dice. It's a good thing craps... And that makes it better, too, chat, because it's, like, only in Vegas and, like, select places, you know? It's an exclusive. If witnesses ask for too high a price, I will cover it. Likewise, our mutual friend will be able to apply some pressure. Stamping out Salieri and his family will be good for us all. These are dangerous times. I worry for your safety and the safety of your family. You will soon receive some men at your home who will protect you. With gratitude, Roberto. Roberto. Roberto!
Scusa.
Sure. Show me what you can do.
Shit. Be quick, Salvatore. Pacenza, Pacenza.
Pacenza. Tommy, dude, let him work. Oh my god, Tommy.
Ed ha collegato l'allarme.
What? Inzappolato.
Doesn't matter. Come on, we need to get
Tommy.
Out of here. Vai dietro, dietro.
Tommy's the muscle, dude. He's not the brains.
Safe in his study.
Hey, over here.
Many fire deaths, dude. Many fire deaths tonight. So many. So what, that's three? Four? Three or four at least.
They gotta be upstairs. The safe's in his study. Yeah. God. Always the fire. Thank you.
Quick health break. Is it below? No, there it is. Why not? Why not? Uh-oh.
Get a better shot! Go!
Sing it!
This one.
Forza! Andiamocene!
Dude, that one. F it. This one. The biggins. Tired, dude. I think we're tired. Oh no! We ran into a bush. We're stuck.
We lost him. Cars and beach hill keep looking. Gotta go far.
Somehow we got away. Oh no! Oh no! Chat. We're gonna make it. We're gonna make it. Oh no! They're coming up. And down! To Pinsir! Oh no. Chat, we're hosed. That's it. Solid bushes, dude. Solid bushes. That's it, dude. Just... Execution. Of course, see? The cops protecting the rich people. Immediately killing us. Mm-hmm. Let's get out of here.
Whatever you're saying, I know.
Oh, frick.
We lost him. Cars and beach hill, keep looking. You gotta go far.
Cristo Santissimo!
I'm trying! I love it.
Yeah, we're home.
Six and Maple.
Okay, let's go.
Please, I'm gonna do it again. Thank you. One more time, chat. Pogo Piton! I love it. Can you imagine, dude, just Tommy slamming in? He's cursing at us, dude, of course. It's all about learning curse words in all languages. That was a cool spot. Really cool spot. Casino chat. Heart eight's a sucker bet, but my brother and I rocked it. And it's a good P.T. Anderson movie.
Impara almeno un po' d'italiano per rispetto della nostra patria. È come parlare al mio cane, lo so, ma Cristo, dovevo dirlo. Non farlo mai più. Mai più.
Ok, ok. Sure.
Maybe we'll get an intermission. We'll go until it gives us control back, then I'll stop. Check on some cutscenes. Time for an intermission, dude. It's been a minute. It's time. Give us that intermission crunch. Nope. Until next time, chat.
This is the last of the good stuff, boss.
I know. Some of those bottles I've had for 10 years. But we gotta make payroll. Get it out of here.
Convert them.
Payroll.
Good to see you, boys.
Boss, any word on a job I pulled with Salvatore?
You did fine, Tom. Galati's got nothing on us now. We bought some time. At least until the money runs out.
Don't go selling off the farm yet, boss.
Sam says you worked out an angle.
Yeah. And you're gonna love it. We make a few bucks and knock out a couple of Morello's teeth, too.
Okay, what's the rumpus?
A couple of weeks ago, I'm relaxing in the cigar lounge at the Blue Tropics.
Where?
Some small-time whorehouse. It's just a couple of closets with some mattresses on the floor.
It's a gentleman's club. They got a bar and everything. Anyways, one of the Johns is south. And he's crying to the madam about all his troubles. He catches my ear on account of his goofy accent. He's going on and on about how he just landed this huge payday. But the goons he's working for are already twisting his arm. And he's got the busted nose to show for it.
You pick up his tab?
Hell no. But I walked him out of the place, took him to the diner around the corner to sober up. We get to talking. Turns out his name is Gates. He's this hick. Up from Kentucky.
Moonshiner?
Better. His pop's got a couple of real distilleries, and I'll give you one guess as to their exclusive buyer around these parts.
Morello.
And you think he wants to burn bridges?
Oh, yeah. I've been working him steady, boss. He's bringing up another shipment tonight, but he's got his entire crew ready to roll over. All we gotta do is make it look like a proper heist.
I don't know, Polly. You really trust this guy?
He's got no love for Morello, I'll tell you that. Not like we got a lot of options here. We'll be cutting up the last beam pretty soon, boss.
What do you think, Tom?
We need to replace the Canadian. If Polly says this Gates can do that, I'm in.
Where's backs him.
The big parking garage.
Tommy backs him.
Okay, do it. But you better not be playing grab ass this time.
Grab ass, dude. My dad uses that. Sure. Playing grab ass.
Drive it back here.
Such a dad one.
We won't let you down, boss.
Don't make me regret giving you some time out there in the streets with the guys, Carlo.
You don't have to worry about me.
I know I don't. Tommy does that for me.
I'll keep your driver safe, boss.
Buona fortuna, boys.
Sam and little Bill set to meet him downtown.
Good interior, see good locations. Alright, chat. September 1933 is where we end. Pretty far in Mafia. That was just the second session, I believe, of Mafia. And yeah, that's gonna do it. Played some classic missions there. Trip to the Country, dude. Big time one. Very memorable in the original. It's very moody, you know. Cinematic. All the missions were cinematic back then, you know. They were all so crafted. Love it. Hotel and stuff. Awesome. All right, chat. It's going to do it. I'm going to go watch the first episode of Resident Evil. It's out, right? It's out. I can go watch that. Pilot episode with Chief Irving and Lieutenant Daniels and Zavala / Lance Reddick. All right, love and respect, chat. Love and respect.